What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And I am somebody who has been diagnosed with a generalized anxiety disorder. So there are many different forms of anxiety. What a GAD is that my anxiety will come from just about anything and from no reason at all. And in this video, I'm gonna share with you one of my favorite anxiety tricks. So make sure that you share this video to help out other people with their anxiety. So most of my videos that I do on this channel, if you've been subscribed to me for a while, like you know, I like to bring in a lot of scientific studies and research, talk about neuroscience, and give you scientifically proven ways to help out with your anxiety, your depression, or even addiction, right? Well, today is a little bit something different because before I became educated on all that stuff, like I had to figure out different things to do just to keep my head straight and quit from losing my mind. So one of the strategies I learned very early on that worked for me, and it might work for you, is learning how to laugh at my anxiety. And that might sound a little crazy at first. No, I'm not asking you to walk around like a lunatic just laughing at random things, but let me explain what I'm talking about. So the phrase I want you to start using, okay, is what's the worst that can happen? Okay, like this is something I constantly had to ask myself when I was dealing with my anxiety, with my panic attacks. Like I had to sit back and look at what I was anxious about, what was happening, and I'd have to sit back and ask, what's the worst that can happen? Now, when you do this, yeah, I'm not talking about like, think some vague stuff like, oh, I'm gonna feel uncomfortable, oh, it's gonna worry me a little bit. No, 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 no. I'm talking about get crazy, okay? Get crazy and think about what's the absolute worst thing. Like, think up a fictional story that is nothing short of laughable. Here's what I mean by this. So for example, part of my anxiety is social anxiety. So I would get worried about just going to the grocery store or going to like an electronics store. Like we have a gigantic electronics store here in Las Vegas called Fry's, and I love that place, but I would get so socially anxious there because it is packed. Like every single tourist and their mom comes down to go shopping here and buy like DVDs and appliances, and I don't know why they all go there, but it would build up a lot of anxiety. And I like to go there too, because I'm a tech nerd, right? And I would have to go in, and once that anxiety started building, that social anxiety, I'm like, what's the worst that could happen? What is the worst thing that could happen by me going to Fry's? And like, I would think up a crazy story, like, what's gonna happen? Is everybody gonna look at me, think I'm a lunatic or a loser, or I'm dumb or stupid, and what are they gonna do? Are they all gonna like jump me and beat the crap out of me until I run away and never come back to Fry's? Like, absolutely not, that's insane. And once I run through that scenario in my head, I can do nothing else but laugh at how crazy my brain works, right? Or if I get down in there a little bit deeper, like, let's say I'm in Fry's and like, somebody just randomly talks to me. Like that is, somebody with social anxiety, that is their worst nightmare. Just some random person talking to you, because our brain goes a million miles a minute. What am I gonna say? What are they gonna say? What am I, is what I'm gonna say gonna be right? Is it gonna be funny? Are they gonna think I'm an idiot? All these things run through our heads. And I would sit there and say, what is the worst thing that's gonna happen, right? Like really, what's the worst thing that's gonna happen if I trip up on my words? If somebody does talk to me, what is the absolute worst thing that's gonna happen? Are they gonna like chase me out of the store? Are they gonna follow me home? Are they gonna like blow up my house or something crazy? Like, no, they're not, you know what I mean? And like I said, when I can run through that scenario in my head, it makes it a lot easier to just kind of sit back, laugh, and cope with it. So I put a question out there on my social media. And by the way, if you're not following me on social media, I don't know what you're doing. Instagram's probably the best place because I put a bunch of like mental health and inspirational stuff on there. So here that link is again for you, all right? But I put out a post and I said, hey everybody, working on a video. List me some things that make you anxious, right? And I actually got a bunch of really good comments, but for the sake of this video, I pulled in one of these comments, and it actually came from a gal named Christina. And one of the things that she talks about that builds up her anxiety is a messy house. So like, I get that, I get that. I get how walking in and like seeing a house that's in disarray, it can start to build up this anxiety, right? And it's like, what's the worst that's gonna happen? What is the worst that's gonna happen to you, Christina? Is the man of your dreams gonna just be happening to be walking through the neighborhood, knock on your door, and you open up the door and he's gonna peek in and just see how messy your house is, and now all of a sudden you have lost your chance at love and you are never gonna meet Prince Charming again, and now you're gonna die alone? Like, think about that for a second. Like, that's nuts. That's not going to happen. You know what I mean? So, like I said, like, go really far out there, really stretch this thing so you can turn it into a laughable situation. Now, on a more serious note though, once we're able to do this, now we're able to work through it a little bit better, right? So going back to Christina's example about having a messy house, like first we laugh about it, step one. Now it's kind of like, okay, now I've created some room between me and my anxiety. I take some deep breaths and say, what is the next thing that I need to do? And I will make more videos on this, but Christina, for the sake of this video, pick a certain area of the house, a very small certain area, whether it's the living room, the kitchen. Let's say it's a kitchen. Focus straight away on the dishes, right? Or on cleaning off the countertops. One very small task in that area, accomplish that, and then do the next very small task. Because something that a lot of us deal with is that we procrastinate or we keep looking at the overwhelming task of the larger situation, but when we can hone in on one specific situation, it actually helps calm down the anxiety and we start getting things done, all right? So anyways, I really hope this video helped you, and like I said at the beginning of this video, even if it didn't help you, quit being so selfish. Go share this video with other people. Let them know about this anxiety trick. Okay, but anyways, if you're new here, make sure that you click this little round subscribe button because I'm always making videos to help you out with your mental and emotional well-being. And if you got some time, make sure you click or tap on one of these thumbnails right here. I got a ton of videos about mental health, mental illness, addiction, and all that stuff, okay? But thanks so much for watching. Laugh at your anxiety today, and I'll see you next time.